The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 25, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 29, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
Akin toyam avitaja ayam uchyate tasmat emam viditya enam nanu shochitam arhasi. So, in so many different ways, Krishna is convincing how the spirit soul is immortal. In different ways, abhaptayam is not manifest to the blunt material eyes. We cannot see. Because, as you have explained several times, the magnitude of the soul is 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair. Very small. I think smaller than the atom. That spirit soul is everywhere. Sarvaga. Sarvagata. Everywhere. Annantarastham paramanutayantarastham. And wherever the spirit soul is there, within this material world, he has got a body and there is heart, and within that heart, Krishna is also there. Ishvara sarvabhutanam riddhesu arjuna tishthati. Both of them living there. Therefore, anoraniyana mahato mahiya. Krishna can become greater than the greatest and the smaller than the smallest. This is God. When Krishna was playing as a child, he ate earth, and the playmate complained to Mother Yashoda, "Mother, your son Krishna is eating earth." Mother Yashoda called for explanation. "Krishna, why you are eating earth? I have given you sandesh." Krishna said, "No, Mother, I have not eaten." "No, your friends are complaining. No, they have become my enemies this morning. We had some quarrel. Therefore, they have combined together to make me chastised by you." So, in this way, then Mother Yashoda wanted to solve this problem. "All right, show your mouth. Open your mouth, I want to see." And when Krishna opened the mouth, the mother saw innumerable universes are within the mouth. This is Krishna. Anoraniyana mahato mahiya. Krishna enters within the universe, but at the same time, millions of universes are within his mouth. This is the explanation of the greater than the greatest and the smaller than the smallest. Of course, Mother Yashoda, although she saw, she could not believe it, because Mother Yashoda never thought of that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. She always thought that he is my teeny child, that's all. I have to take care of him. This is called paternal feeling. Vatsalya rasa. Krishna is fed by the devotees in so many rasas, transcendental mellow or humor. somebody is serving a servant, somebody is serving as friend, somebody is serving as father and mother, somebody is serving as conjugal lover. These are five primary mellows in which a devotee is connected with Krishna. And there are other seven rasas also. They are not primary, secondary. Somebody is serving Krishna as enemy. Just like the Asuras, they also serve Krishna as enemy. Somebody is serving, giving pleasure to Krishna by fighting with him. So there are so many 12 rasas. Akhila rasa amrita sindhu. All the rasas that we have got experience within this world, they are coming from Krishna. Janmadvasya jataha. The Vedanta Sutra says, everything, whatever we see within our experience, we cannot experience anything if it is not in Krishna. That is Krishna. He is stealing, which we consider not very good business, that stealing is also in Krishna. He is famous as Makhan Chok, the stealer of butter. So this is Krishna. Everything is there. Whatever our dealings in this material world, we find that is only perverted reflection of our dealing with Krishna in the spiritual world. But those who are unaware of the spiritual world, impersonalists, they have no information that Krishna is always busy. Jai Radha Madhava Kunya Vihari. He is always busy, he is person. But he is simply dear to the Gopijana, Gopijana Vallava. He wants to please the Gopijanas. The Gopis, the cowherd boys and the Gopis, the constant companion of Krishna. So, this is Sanatana. Krishna is Sanatana and his dealing with his devotees, that is also Sanatana. And these are possible not here, but in the Sanatana Dham. We cannot have Sanatana dealing with Krishna within this material world. Therefore, Krishna comes to canvas the conditioned soul that for eternal happiness, for eternal dealing, you come to me in my eternal place. Jadgatyana nivartante taddhama paramamma. Why not in this material world? No. The material world, the nature is, it is not permanent. It is temporary. Bhutta bhutta praliyate janmadasya janmadi. Everything here in this material world has a death of birth. And anything which has a death of birth must be a death of death also. That is the nature of this material. So, here we can practice what is Sanatana Dharma. But actually Sanatana Dharma is executed in the spiritual world. So, just like one is trained up to become apprentice in some business, and when he is trained up, then he is given the post. So we get this information from the Goswamis, Sanatana Goswamis, that those who are devotees, Those who are perfected in the training of devotional service, they are first of all given birth in the universe where Krishna is present. Krishna is always present. Just like the sun is present always in the sky, but we can see the sun in some opportune moment. But sun is always there. When the sun is set, it is set in my vision, but sun is there. When it is night, I cannot see the sun, but the sun is there. Similarly, Krishna is always there. We have to make our eyes to see Him. That's all. And that's how that eyes are made. Premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayan jang shama sundaram achinta gunasvarupam govindam adipurusam tamaham bhajam. Only the devotees who have loving affection for Krishna, who has developed loving propensity. The loving propensity is there already. But we have transferred the loving propensity to Krishna, we have transferred the loving propensity to the Maya. The whole Krishna consciousness process is again transferring the loving propensity from Maya to Krishna. This is the simple method. We have got love for Krishna, but being illusion, being falsely positioned, we are trying to love something which is not Krishna. Maya. Krishna is Maya, illusion. Mama Maya. Krishna says Maya is also mine. Just like this cloud. What is this cloud? This is also made by the sun. Everyone, you know. The cloud means the sun evaporates water from the ocean and it becomes cloud. And the business of the cloud is to cover our eyes to see the sun. Actually, the cloud has no existence, separate existence. And as soon as the sun is bright, the cloud disappears. This is bhutta bhutta praliyate. It comes into existence and again it disappears. This is Maya. But the sky remains there, the sun remains there. Similarly, Maya, illusion, is sometimes is generated. This is the creation of the material world, mahatattva, Maya. So, this is not permanent. It comes and goes. Similarly, Maya is simply covering our eyes. Just like this cloud, it is not possible for the cloud to cover the sun. The sun is 93 million, at least 1400,000 times bigger than this earth. So how a cloud spreading over, say, a few miles, 10 miles, it can cover the sun? No. The cloud cannot cover the sun, but the cloud can cover my eyesight. This is the point. Similarly, Maya cannot touch Krishna. The Mayavadi philosophy is that Maya also covers Krishna. When Krishna comes here, he comes covered by this Maya. No, this is not. Maya cannot touch. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, when Vyasadeva realized Krishna before writing Srimad Bhagavatam, bhakti yogi namanasa sammak pranihuti amali apashat purusam param mayan sudad apasya So Vyasadev by his meditation saw the Supreme Person and Maya also. Maya is on the back side. Maya cannot come in the front side. So Krishna is never covered by Maya. It is our eyes who is covered by Maya. So we, the fragments of Krishna, Mamaivansa, we are covered by Maya, not Krishna. The theory that Krishna becomes covered, that is nonsense. How Krishna can be covered? Krishna cannot be covered. He is the controller of the Maya. And we are controlled by the Maya. That is the difference. Krishna Maya Dhis and we are Maya Adhin. Then we can become free. Exactly the same example that when our eyes are covered by the cloud, we cannot see the sun, although the sun is there. So if somehow or other we have got very good experience nowadays by flying in the airship. As soon as the airship goes above the cloud, you have got immense sunlight. And practically the jet planes, they go 7 miles above the surface and there is no cloud. The cloud is down. Similarly, you can go also above Maya. You can transcend Maya and see Krishna always. That is possible. How? Mami vaja prapadanti mayami tal saranti. You simply surrender to Krishna and Krishna will arrange that you are no more under Maya. Simple path. You just become, as Krishna demands, sarvadharman paritajya mamekam saranam vaja. This is Sanatana Dharma. Because we are, after all, servant of Krishna. But artificially, we are trying to become master of this world. That we are therefore sent here. Just like those who are revolutionary, do not care for the state laws. They are sometimes killed, or sometimes put into the prison house. That means those who are not voluntarily surrendering to Krishna, they are put into the prison house, they are forced to surrender. Forced to surrender. They will be forced. It's like you cannot become, you are not free either outside the prison house or inside the prison house. But when you think that you have become free, vimukta manino. Vimukta manino. Falsely thinking that I am now become liberated. Abhisuddha buddha. But the intelligence is not very clear. This is last snare of Maya. When one thinks that I am God, I have become God, that is the last snare of Maya. That is also Maya. How you can become God? What capacity you have got? God has created so many things. What you have created? God has shown so many things. What you have done? But still, falsely that thinking, I am God. This is Maya. Last snare of Maya. Because the real disease, as you have already explained, is to lord it over the material nature. Everyone is trying. I am the Lord of all I survey. I want to become Lord of this universe. I want to become minister. I want to become president. I want to become business magnitude. And everything fails. Then he wants to become God. That is also Maya. That is not possible. So, this is going on. The real our relationship with God, Krishna, is to serve. Jiver sarup hoy nitya Krishna das. Anadi bahirmukh ji Krishna bhuli gela. Ataya Krishna ved purana kariya. We have forgotten real position, Sanatan Dharma. We have forgotten. Sanatan Dharma means a living entity is meant for serving the whole. Living entity is a part of the whole. So, the living entity's business is to serve the whole. Just like this finger. This finger is a part of my body. Its business is to carry out my order to serve the whole. I want the finger to come here immediately. Similarly, our business is to serve Krishna. But when we want to become Lord, independent of Krishna, that is called Maya. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhogavan chakar. Pasete maya tare japotiya dhare. This is a statement in the Prem Vimarta. As soon as we desire to imitate Krishna, that is Maya. Maya is nothing. We create that situation of Maya. What is that? I want to become Krishna, I want to become God, I want to become the Lord. This is Maya. This is not Maya. So, Krishna is Sanatan, we are also Sanatan. But when we forget to serve Krishna, that is our Asanatan. And when we are engaged again in the service of Krishna, that is Sanatan Dharma. So, Sanatan Dharma means eternally serving Krishna. Another example, Dharma. What is Dharma? Dridhat. Characteristic. You cannot change it. You cannot change it. Just like sugar. Sugar characteristic means sweetness. And chili characteristic means pungent. So everything has got characteristic. Everything. That is called Dharma. If sugar has become pungent and chili has become sweet, you purchase chili. If it is not, pungent, you say, it is not good. Because the dharma of the chili is lacking. Similarly, if you take sugar and if you find it salty, then you say, what is this? So, everything has got some characteristics. So, we are living entities. We have got our characteristics. That is Sanatana. I am Sanatana, Hitana. And my characteristic is to serve God. If I don't serve God, then the characteristic will remain there, then I will have to serve Maya. In the illusion that I have become master, actually he is serving. But just like one man has got a motor car. So motor car, to maintain a motor car, to purchase a motor car requires lots of money. So get that money, he has to work very hard. And when he gets that money, he purchases a car. And then he has to maintain it by oiling, by supplying, so many things. But he is thinking that now I have got a motor car. Very nice. What is that? You are serving your motor car, that's all. So this is the position. One is actually serving, not master, but he is thinking that he is master. This is master. So, when we give up this false prestigious position that I am master, then you are liberated. Hitya annatharupam. Mukti, the definition of mukti is hitva annatharupam sarupena avasthiti. Annatharupam. Now we are struggling hard within this material world under the influence of maya. Changing different types of body. Sometimes I am going to the heavenly planet, sometimes I am going to the hellish planet. Sometimes I'm rich man, sometimes I'm poor man, sometimes Brahmin, sometimes Shudra, sometimes tiger, sometimes tree. In this way, Sarvagata, everywhere within this universe, the living entities are struggling for existence. Manasasthani indriyani, prakitisthani karasati. Mama Ivansa Jiyo. Krishna says, all these living entities, they are my part and parcel, but foolishly, carried by the mental concoction, prakitisthani within this material world, karasati, struggling to become master. This is the disease. Prakitisthani karasati. Prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa ahankara vimuratma karta aham iti mannate. These rascals, they are pulled by the ear, by prakriti. Prakite kriyamanani. You can do this. I have to do this. One who has associated with the tamagun of prakriti, prakriti has given a body just like hog. And prakriti is obliging. We come here, eat this food, and he is eating. Oh, so nice. This is master. This stool is very nice thing. But prakriti has given this hog a certain type of body, and he is relishing. Oh, stool is so nice. This is why. Similarly, in human form of body also. They are eating. So many nonsense things. And the restaurant in the hotel, and they're releasing, oh, it is so nice. This is Maya. This is going on. So, our business is to serve. But, because we are taking this attitude, that I don't like to serve Krishna, or I am Krishna, then we are under the clutches of Maya. Immediately. And under the illusion of Maya, Pakite Kriyamanani, Gunai Karma, Karanam Gunasanga Asa, Sadasad Janma Jonishu. Because we are associating with the different modes of material nature, therefore, we have to take birth, Sadasad Janma Jonishu. One is becoming hog, one is becoming dog, one is becoming human being, one is becoming demigod, one is becoming tree, one is becoming plant. So many, 8,400,000 of species and forms of life. Krishna says, Sarvajonishu Kantra. Krishna says, all these forms, whatever they may be, I am the Bija Padapita, I am the father. So, if Krishna is the original father of every living entity, how one has become Brahmana, one has become Shudra, one has become tree, one has become tiger, one has become hog, one has become Indra, one has become Brahma? How is that? Now, Karanam Gunasangasya Sadasad Janma Jonishu. So, we are getting our birth in different types of body. The reason is, I am associating with different types of the modes of nature. My mind is carrying. It is not death. It is foolish to say that this man is not dead, everything is finished. That is not carried out, not finished. It is going on. Na hannate hannamane sarire. The foolish rascals say, now, this man is dead, finished. Big, big professor. They are saying, Ramiji, after death, everything is finished. And he is professor, they see. Rascal fools, they are becoming leaders, professors, politicians. So how the people will be happy? They are put into the ignorance of life. All effort. Nothing we do, sartagating, he be slow. Durasayadri Bhushirathamanina. They have been enamored by the external feature of Krishna's energy. This is also Krishna's energy, this material world. But we are attracted by this material energy. We should be attracted by the spiritual energy. That is perfection of both energies are Krishna's. Apara, para. This is explained in Bhagavad Gita. So we are now attracted by the apara energy. Bhumi rapana lo vayu. This material element we want. Because we are attracted by the material energy. Therefore, when we construct a very nice stone house, we think, now yes, my life is success. I have got a very nice house made of stone. Are you stone? No. Still, my attraction is for the stone. Therefore, Krishna gives me facility. All right, you take this stone and try to, but you will never be happy. Happy you will be when you surrender to me. Just like a child is given by the father all facilities to play. But at the same time, the father says, my dear child, don't play like this, it is not good. But because the child persists, father sometimes says, all right, you play like that. Similarly, Krishna does not want that we should come in this material world and be attracted by the earth, water, air, fire and become great scientists and make combination of these five elements. Tejo barimit vinimayam. What is this world? This world is a mixture of fire, earth, water, air, that's all. What is this? Tejo barimit vinimayam. Tisarga, Mrisha. It is a false thing. Actually, it is a combination of these five elements. And we are accepting. This body is also like that. Body is also a combination of five elements. And we are attracted to this. Oh, I've got so lucky, such a nice, beautiful body, strong body, American body, Indian body, Brahman body, this body, that body, all mine. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.